Okay, guys, thank you for joining us. I'm Mark Harris. I'm a program leader of the course for Media Production and Technology. It's a UAL course, and it ranges from a level 2 diploma all the way up to a level 3 extended diploma, which is equivalent to 3 A-levels. And joining me today are four of the students who have been on the course this last year, and I thought it'd be a really good idea for them to actually answer your questions instead of me, because that way, you know, you hear it directly from these guys, and these guys are the ones who have been through the course and are currently involved in it. So introduce yourself first. Let's start at the top left here. So
My name's Christopher Whitaker. I'm one of the first year level 3 students on the media course.
What school did you come from, Chris?
I came from Fleetwood High School.
Okay. Jack, introduce yourself.
I am Jack. I'm pretty cool. I came from Warrington School, which no one will know the name of.
So you moved to Blackpool, didn't you, just as the course started?
I did move to Blackpool, okay. Yeah.
Travis?
Hi, my name's Travis. I'm a first-year student on the Creative Media Production course. I came from Luton St. Anne's High.
And finally, Kyle.
Hello, I'm Kyle. I'm on a level 3 media course, media production. I'm also studying maths and English as well. I started last year, and I came from a collegiate high school, which is now shut down.
Won't blame it on you.
No.
Okay, so what I've got is, I actually had a list of quite a lot of frequently asked questions, which we get on open days and interviews. So I've just tried to shorten them down into the 10 most commonly asked. So it'd be nice for you guys to give us your opinions and what you know about these. So let's start with you, Chris. How many days am I in college? What time does it start and end?
I'm generally in college for the media classes 4 days a week, but I also do English classes on Wednesdays, so I'm in technically 5 days a week. Classes genuinely start at around 9:45 in the morning, and classes normally run through until about 4:30 in the afternoon.
So what about you guys that aren't involved in any maths or English sessions? What's your week look like?
One less day than that, really. I mean, we do have a half day on Tuesday, so I don't know if that counts as like 3.5 days.
Okay, so it can vary between 3.5 days and 5 days a week, yeah? Okay, just going round to you then, Jack. Next question. Is the work hard, and do I get homework?
I wouldn't say it's hard. It's just you pay attention to what you're doing, and it's pretty easy, and not homework if you don't mess about. You don't need to do anything at home. You just get it all done in class, really.
What do you think about that, guys? Do you think that's true?
Yeah. I mean, if you focus on your work, then you don't necessarily have to do any work at home, but it helps to work from home as well, catching up on everything and being up to date with everything.
But it progresses your skills as well, obviously.
Yeah, it's encouraged to also work at home as well to develop your skills, because it's college, it's not high school anymore. You don't just work when you're there. You're encouraged to, obviously work in class, but when you're out of it, put things that you learn into practice to develop your skills and such.
Yeah.
Okay, next question. Travis, this is a big one we always get asked. Are there any exams?
No. It's a BTEC. There's no exams, right?
It's not a BTEC, it's a UAL, but yeah, it's similar, because it's classed as a vocational course, so yeah, there's no exams. So how do you get graded then? How does that work?
Get graded off coursework.
Cool. Okay, Kyle, do we do much practical work?
Yeah, most of all, if not all of it, is practical. Like, we've got a lot of certain written elements and stuff that we have to undertake, but when we do practical projects, they are kind of, they're big, and we do all sorts of stuff, like all sorts of areas, like with audio and editing, or going out on the field and like filming stuff. We do all sorts of stuff, like in practicality.
I think there's a good balance between the two. Oh, sorry.
Yeah, no, go ahead. We got a nice balance between the two, I think.
Oh, glad you think that way. Great. Okay, another one we get asked, do I need any equipment? Do you need to have your own computer? Do you need to have your own laptop? Do you need to have a hard drive? Tell me what you need.
No, No, it does help to have your own equipment, but everything is provided on the course.
Yeah, although a hard drive, you do need a hard drive for the working stuff because you don't have enough space on your own laptop, I'd assume anyway. But you'd rather have a hard drive specifically for all your media stuff anyway, so you know where it is and it's all organised. So
I do use a pen drive myself, like a big pen drive. You don't necessarily have to have a big hard drive. It does help, and it is more, it's more beneficial for you to have a big hard drive. But I've managed to get through this entire year with nothing but an 8 GB pen drive and a 32 GB SD card. So,
yeah, and you're not required to have you're not required to have computers in Mac, so to speak, because all that's provided at the college for you to use. Obviously, it's beneficial if you do have your own computer or Mac. You have near enough the best equipment at the college anyway to use whenever whenever the college.
You've got the library as well and the loop. You got all sorts of stuff that you can get out of there in terms of books and everything you'd ever want.
Yeah, I just want to clarify, we obviously don't loan out computers or MacBooks or anything. You get use, obviously, of the ones in college. And like you said, you can go to a lot of library or loop and log in and continue your work there. Yeah. But if you've got a PC or a Mac at home, it doesn't have to be a Mac. You can obviously use it to catch up and do other things. So have all you guys got PCs at home or Macs?
I've got a PC.
Yeah, I use a PC.
Yeah, got a PC.
I've just got quite a basic laptop myself because I normally go into college to carry on with my work anyway.
Okay, cool. So again, you ain't gonna spend to get what you need.
No.
I don't know if this affects some of you guys. Some people ask us about how do I get to college. Does anybody use for college bus routes?
I get bus every day back and forth.
Okay, how does that work out? Do you have to pay for it or?
No, I get a college bus pass.
Okay, how often do the buses run? What route do you want? Do you go on?
I'm 17. So it's the 17 bus that goes to St. Anne's to Blackpool.
Okay. And how many buses are there on a morning or an evening?
I get two.
Right, so it's just the general Blackpool Transport bus route, is it?
Yeah.
Jump on. Right, okay, cool. So it's pretty straightforward, yeah? One I do get, because we get quite a lot of school leavers come to us, and sometimes we're a little bit concerned about not knowing anybody on the course because they're new here. We've obviously spent quite a lot of time in their previous schools, building up friendship groups, etc. So, I mean, how did you guys feel about when you came here and not knowing anybody?
Well, for me, I was very shy. I've got sort of bad social anxiety, so for when I first came here, I was sort of scared about who to mingle with. But after a little while, it was a couple of days, I started speaking to a few people, and now I've got sort of friends for life now at the college. Like, I've got my own friendship circles, and even bumped into old people that I'd known from high school and stuff like that. Like, it's a nice mix for me. But even if you don't know anyone, I've made so many friends with people I've got a lot of friends there now, so it's great. And I don't really, I didn't think I could like meet new people and bond with new people, but the people that go to the college are genuinely one of the nicest people I've ever met. So
I'd agree with that, because as soon as I joined the course, I was like the same as Carl, kind of. I didn't really I think it was like for the first month I didn't really speak to anyone, but I've got to say Chris made it feel very welcome. Chris and Alex, because they're just the elders. Oh, obviously Kyle as well, but. Yeah.
With me having a bit of an age gap between the other students, I'm 27 myself, so I was a bit apprehensive because I didn't know whether it was just going to be loads of, you know, school leavers and all that joining the course. I did go to a summer school that was held to get a taster for the course, which is something I would urge people thinking about joining the course to go to, so you can get an idea and you can also meet some like-minded people. So if you do actually come onto the course, there will be people there that you already know, that you spoke to from summer school, that helped me as well.
Yeah, the summer school is a really nice icebreaker for those which come to it. That way they come to us in the first week and they sort of know each other. So Jack, how was it for you? Because you totally came from out of a region, didn't you? So was it a bit scary for you?
I mean, yeah, I was a bit nervous, but like half the course didn't know each other already, so it was pretty much fine. Once you realise that, everyone's on the same boat, so I felt fine.
Great. Are the tutors strict? Who wants to have a go at that one?
I mean, I think there's a, it's a weird divide, because I think at certain times you can be strict, Mark, but I don't. Gabby's like very laid back, so it's like a good balance.
Anyone want to agree or disagree there?
Yeah, there's for me. Sorry, suck over you, Kyle. For me, no. The tutors tell you what they want from you, but they're not strict. It's not like someone screaming at you and ordering you to do stuff. You get told what you need to do, but they'll prod you like, you know, the deadline's coming up. Make sure, you know, you're keeping up your work and getting it completed. But no, there's no super strict like tutors or evil headmasters or something like that. If people are apprehensive about that, yeah.
Well, at the end of the day, we're all here to learn a subject that we're wanting to follow, and they're not. In the college, that our teachers aren't meant to be ordering us around and being strict with things. It's more of a case of they want to work with you and be on your level. So, like, for example, let me think here. It was in my head and my brain just lost it.
No, what I was going to say as well is some people might be introverted in very, you know, like social anxiety and quite nervous, apprehensive. Mm. I've seen the tutors engage with people that are extroverts, people that are introverts, and they communicate with them clearly and very well. I've heard no complaints from other students or anything like that. I've thought the tutors have been great engaging with people from all sorts of, well, walks of life, basically.
If you have a passion for film and or photography or anything to do with this college, you're going to get somewhere. But if you come to this course and you have no interest in it, and they will pick up on this, because people do come and go in all sorts of courses on all sorts of campuses. But if you come on this course, you have to have a passion for this. You have to want to do it. And then they'll work with you on your level. But if you're having no care in it, then they will be strict on you. They will get you into that mindset of wanting to do it and getting to do it, because it is a lot of fun and it is very rewarding.
Well, that's part of the reason why we're doing this today, is sort of for people that are interested in the course and thinking about it, they're going to get a clear view about what it's about, what's expected, you know, and yeah, hopefully we'll make the right decision that this is a course for them. Or if not, then we'll find a course which is appropriate for them. That's really important, isn't it? Okay, last question then. I'll go around the screen on this. So have a little think. What's the best part of the course? Coming to you first, Chris.
Oh, I'm going to sound like I'm being a bit of a suck up here, but I love all parts of the course.
You're going to say my lessons?
Oh, no, specifically Gabby. Her lessons are wonderful. We survived, Mark. No, all the classes are great. I initially came in with a keen interest in working wildlife documentaries. Also, I still do have a keen interest in radio. But my eyes have been open to like the editing side and the actual filmmaking thing, and my passion for them has developed even just over the first year of the course. Now my eyes have been open to all the different possibilities. There's literally endless possibilities. So I love everything, because I'm learning something new every single time, and the skills that I did have originally have just shot up from the knowledge from people in the class, classmates, I mean, and also the tutors. And people on the higher levels of the course who are open to helping us and such as well.
Okay, Jack, what do you reckon? What's been your favourite part of the course?
Personally, from what we've done, I like learning the new skills, but I've very much enjoyed the practical, going out and filming stuff. It's obviously something you can learn editing from home, or you can learn script writing wherever else, but a lot of the practical stuff we do, I've never seen a chance to do it like anywhere else. Certainly not in Warrington. There were no courses like this at all. So all the practical skills are really good, and I enjoy learning them.
Travis?
To bounce off from what Chris said, like the knowledge I've gained from the course, like I like honestly believe every time we have a lesson I gain something new. And but another thing as well is, I think one of the best parts of the course is like all the new friends I've met because like you're working with like-minded people and it's like a great experience when you're filming out and stuff.
Thank you, Kyle.
For me, it's the creative freedom that I've had with doing every project that we've worked on. And like prior to all this, I was doing things that I didn't really enjoy in life. I didn't really have any passion for, but I came onto this course with a passion to get somewhere in the film industry or to get somewhere within my area of interest. And everything that we've worked on, it's been an amazing experience. And having to use my creativity and my mindset to make something and put it into something I enjoy, it's definitely amazing. It's a wonderful experience, and it's probably one of the best decisions I've ever made to join this course, to be honest, in complete honesty.
Really appreciate that. Okay, one question which is not on my list here, and I'll let anybody dive in here, just to be honest, because some of them are going to want to know this. What's the worst part of a course?
Probably your students not putting stuff in on time.
I honestly can't think, because I do truly enjoy everything on the course.
Well, do you know, like I was saying, that some people don't like Brussels sprouts, do they? You know, but they say you've got to eat your vegetables, maybe, to because it's good for you. What's for nasty vegetables? Go for it.
For me, it's the car park. I drive myself, and if you don't get there early enough, all the spots are gone. You've got nowhere to park in some of the surrounding area. You've got to have a permit to park, so you can't park there. So you've got to park about 15 minutes away from the college.
I can't do all about that, Chris. Anything to do with the course.
You can't, he's lying. But that's literally like the only complaint I'd have. But like Mark said, it's nothing to do with the course or anything like that.
Oh, great. I'm loving your silence on that question. Not too much coming in. Anything else you'd like to say, guys? Anything that a little message or short you might say to people that are considering this course and thinking about coming to join us?
Do it.
Yeah,
best decision ever.
Seriously, go for it.
Yeah,
it took me. I originally went onto a computing course when I left school, even though I did have an interest in film and television. I got prodded towards going to that by other people, and it took me 10 years to finally choose the course that I wanted to do originally. And I've gone for it, and it's the best thing I've done in a long, 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 long time.
Yeah, I'm on the same page as you, to be honest. I for a long time, it was around about, as soon as I left, it was the same story. As soon as I left high school, I went into paint spraying and I didn't enjoy it. I didn't like it. And then I moved into different jobs, like doing hit reporting and stuff like that. And I was like, you know, I've had a passion for film my entire life. And I just went for it one day. I just woke up and, you know, I was like, you know what? I'm going to apply for film school. I'm going to apply for college. I'm going to go for something I really want to actually do. And I went for it and I got accepted, and it was the best thing that's ever happened, honestly. I'm enjoying it every second. It's brilliant. Yeah.
And there's,
I highly recommend it. If you even have a slight passion
as well.
If you have a passion for film, go for it, because it's an amazing experience.
You don't even have to just have specifically an interest in film. It could be just in television, that sort of thing as well. Or like I said originally, radio or wildlife filmmaking. There's stuff to do with that as well. So you don't just have to be like a big film buff. Don't think you have to be that to go on the course.
Yeah.
Okay, guys, we're going to draw a line under it there. Thank you very much. I really appreciate you taking the time to answer these questions, and hope they're a lot more believable than me just spouting out the usual responses. We get to hear them directly from you guys, and you guys are obviously finishing your first year now. So thank you very much and appreciate your time. Yeah, bye.
Bye.
No problem.
Yeah, see you later.